My name is Ryan Peer. I'm the Marketing and Recruitment Specialist for Waterloo Engineering. And today I'm going to talk to you about some of the highlights of Waterloo Engineering, as well as some of the differentiators and the student experience. But before we get into too much of the detail, I want to give you a little bit of a backdrop with regards to why Waterloo Engineering is the way it is. And you have to go back to 1957, the year we were founded. The founding members of the university realized that there was a growing gap between the engineers at the time, who were the thinkers, the ones that actually put the blueprints together, and the builders, the ones who actually had the physical skills to develop and create with their ideas. And so they wanted to develop engineers that actually had those physical skills to build with their own ideas and build with the blueprints. And so that's why co-op was founded. It was a completely novel idea at the time, and one that is the foundation of the university. We are the largest faculty of engineering in Canada. We offer 14 undergraduate programs in the faculty. And each of these programs are bound by the Canadian Engineering Accreditation Board, which means there's going to be similarities across them. But we do allow our students to take options and specializations, which are going to give them an opportunity to stream their degree into what their interests are. And so they will graduate with these options on their degree, will be listed, and it allows them to be able to narrow down their scope of specialization into an area of interest to them. There are 11 options currently available. Some options are only available for certain programs, whereas others like artificial intelligence are available for all programs. The one thing that I want people to understand is that we are different with regards to how we operate. And it's really the sum of our differences is something that you can't really compare when you're looking at different institutions. We have direct entry engineering programs. So you'll be starting with program-specific material right from day one. And we also are 100% co-op. Now, those two are some of the major differences, but also the experiential learning component to Waterloo Engineering is something that really sets us apart. Now, with regards to direct entry, there are a lot of benefits for having this type of curriculum. It reduces class sizes. So you'll be starting in a program-specific course curriculum right from your first year, so you won't have a large 300 to 500 seat general engineering class. You'll be focused in with your classmates in that particular program. It allows you to take more technical electives at the back end of your degree as well, so you really get a chance to focus in a particular area, which is what also allows you to take those specializations. Now, cooperative education is one of the main reasons why students will come to Waterloo Engineering. We are the original co-op education program, and it's certainly something that has continued to grow with our faculty. There are lots of benefits for co-op. Obviously, you can finance your education. It's a great way to pay for books and pay for tuition. Opportunity to explore different career opportunities. And then obviously gaining that hands-on experience in different areas. So when you graduate, you've got a wide breadth of physical skills that you can apply to whatever your career may be. As far as co-op at Waterloo, we are the largest co-op institution in the world. 100% of our engineering students are in co-op, so you don't need to apply to co-op after you gain entry, and you will gain up to 2 years of full-time work experience. With regards to how our co-op works, we're not the only one that offers work experience. Other institutions certainly see the value in providing work experience, but the way in which we offer it is going to be different. We basically alternate between a work term and an academic term. And so there's two streams that most students are in. Stream 4, meaning that students will start co-op after 4 months of academics. And then stream 8 is where students will alternate between work and academic sequences after 8 months of academics. And then alternate all the way through. Both streams offer their benefits, but it also allows students to be on work term when the other half of the class may be on the academic term, so the job prospects are easier to obtain. As far as getting a job, once you arrive on campus, you'll be taking the co-op fundamentals course. It'll set you up with the necessary skills to be able to successfully gain employment. They'll help with writing your resume critiquing, and once you have your resume set, you will upload it. You apply to as many jobs as you want. Some students will apply to as many as 40 or 50 jobs in an academic term. And then once you get interviews, you'll then rank employees and you'll get a match. And that's how employment is obtained. The TATHAM Center is where the magic happens. It's the largest co-op building in North America. We have over 140 employees. It's work through the TATHAM Center, and it's where all the interviews take place. So there will be one-to-one interview rooms, but if a company is interviewing a student from abroad, we also have video conferencing rooms where the interviews will take place. Being the largest co-op institution in the world is certainly a benefit for our students. We have over 7,000 different employers that actively recruit from our student population each term. And there's opportunities to travel abroad as well, with 1,800 international co-ops just last year for engineering alone. Earnings are quite competitive. Across first year to final year, you'll get on average $15,000, just under $16,000, $15,800. And employment percentages are quite high as well, with 98% faculty employment across all programs. Now, I mentioned we're not the only institution that offers work experience. Other institutions will offer what they call internships. Now, the difference between internships and our style of work experience is that internships are co-op or work terms that are going to be longer, so between 12 and 16 months. So it's a real deep dive into one particular company and one particular job, whereas ours is really about career exploration. So six different four-month work terms where you get a chance to test drive different careers, different companies, and you really get a sense of what's out there and really build your skill set. So both provide great opportunities to gain experience while you're at an institution studying engineering, but with Waterloo, our focus is really surrounding that career exploration. As far as preparing for co-op, you can prepare starting right in high school, whether that's getting a part-time job or any volunteer work. It really doesn't matter what the job is. It's just as long as it's work experience is going to be what's important to a future employer. So you can start building your resume right away. We do have a co-op fundamentals course that students will take when they're here. And then there's mock interviews that are provided by our engineering society, our undergraduate office, or even in the TATHAM Center. So lots of opportunities to gain experience before you even have to do that first job interview. Student experience is obviously an important part of any student's overall time at the university. So it's something that we believe is very important, and there's lots of ways for students to get involved outside of the classroom and outside of co-op terms. Within the faculty, we have one of the largest and most active engineering societies in Canada. Lots of opportunity to get involved within the faculty, whether it's with the Engineering Society, which is the largest, one of the largest and most active engineering societies in Canada. And it's really like a scaled up version of a student council. They provide all kinds of resources, whether it's tutoring or mock interviews or helping with cover letter writing. But they also have a lot of fun things to get involved with, like trips to concert or parades or even wireless LAN parties. Outside of the faculty, there's also a ton of ways to get involved, whether it's with athletics or intramurals or on-campus groups. For instance, all varsity athletes on campus, 17% are engineering students, which really is an example of how you can still focus on your academics as well as getting co-op jobs, but still provide serious commitments outside of the faculty. A lot of students will want to take advantage of the international opportunities, whether that's working abroad, as I mentioned. But there's also exchange programs where students can take their same academic term at a different institution abroad and really gain that international experience in the academic area. Design teams, as I mentioned, are very popular. We have the Sedgwick Student Design Center, which is a very unique space where a lot of our teams are based, where they have their own garages that they can access 24 hours a day to work on whatever their design team is competing in. They're basically competitive teams that compete against other universities across Canada and even across the world. So there's international competitions that will take place. We have over 20 different design teams to choose from, whether it's race car teams or alternative fuels. We even have a Hyperloop team, and there's even an aquaponics team. So there's really something for everyone. It's a great opportunity for collaboration. You can collaborate with students in your same program, but in upper years, or learning from students in different engineering programs. We even have students from different faculties that will join the teams, such as business students that will help with the marketing and promotion of the design team. So the collaboration opportunity within the design teams is something that is really important, and it's another way that students can really gain from the experiential learning opportunities that are available on campus. Speaking of experiential learning, the Ideas Clinic is something that has been developed since we created our brand new engineering building, which is Engineering 7. And what this is a completely convertible space that professors can take advantage of to supplement their classroom material. So they can do a lecture, and then at the end of the lecture, take their class over for the next class to the Ideas Clinic, and they can actually apply whatever it is that they're learning about. It's a completely convertible space for any engineering program that we offer. So something that really allows our students to take their hands-on learning to the next level. Capstone design projects are something that students will have to compete in their final year. And it's a way for them to build or develop or create something from their ideas and their knowledge that they've gained from the classroom, from their co-op experience, and also from the design teams. Through these capstone design projects, it's where a lot of the engineering startups will come from. They'll take their capstone design project and develop it into a successful business. There's lots of student resources available once students arrive on campus. An example of that is the first year office. So it's an office of professionals, both professors and counselors that are there to really help with the transition from high school to your first year engineering. They've been around for decades, and they basically have a blueprint to help students through any problem that may possibly come up. An excellent resource, and if you talk to our current students that have taken advantage of it, they will all tell you that it is something that has really helped that transition be as smooth as possible. The engineering society, as I mentioned, is another area where students can really take advantage of the resources that they offer. And there's lots of wellness opportunities on campus, whether it's through counseling or MATES, which is a program that pairs students that are maybe going through similar difficulties. And then there's the City of Waterloo, which is a very unique city. We have three higher education institutions all on the same street, and it equals about 60,000 students at any given time. So you'll be surrounded by like-minded individuals that'll be going through the exact same thing as you. So it's a nice, comfortable place for students at any point during the year. With regards to transportation, we have stops right on campus for Grand River Transit, as well as the new Ion train. There's also GO buses that you can catch on campus that'll take you to downtown Toronto, which is only about an hour's drive. Overall, there's about 500,000 people in the Tri-City area. So it is a populous area, but it doesn't take long to get out of town to, say, St. Jacob's Market, which is about a 10-minute drive where students will take advantage of fresh produce and fresh meat from the farmer's market. So if you want to follow us on any of our social media channels, we are very active, as well as on YouTube, where we have a lot of educational videos that are covering information about each of the programs. We would certainly recommend that. Thank you for listening, and we hope to see you on campus sometime soon.